Hello and welcome to Bump Love. We are at Allure Hotel and Suites located in Mutundwe. I think you can see how beautiful they are. You can use them for leisure. You have guests and you want to come here and chill. Family staycation. You know, Ugandans in the diaspora who come back for holiday. And so on and so forth. Work, you know, you want to just do this project, expatriates, and you just want to be in a space where you're not disturbed. Allure is the place to be.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, Bump Love mothers, when we have children, you all know a lot happens to our bodies. Your boobs start to sag, parts of the body are not in place. A lot is happening, lots of changes, and most times it's agitating. You look back and you miss the old 20-year-old who was firm and all cute. Ladies, what are you doing or what do you plan to do or what have you done after you had children just to ensure that, man, you're not letting yourself go, you're putting yourself back together. Yeah? So that, you're that mother that can be looked up to.
Kegels. Now we don't know the science, but there are muscles inside
the privates.
Yes, they are. Yes, which loosen. Actually, people think that those muscles loosen for ladies who have had vaginal births.
Okay.
But they actually loosen in the last trimester when you're carrying the baby. Yeah. When the baby's head, when the baby turns and the head is nested on your cervix, that's when the muscles actually, well, as long as the baby is putting pressure down there, the muscles start to loosen.
Yeah.
So there'll always be a loosening. And then there are Kegels. It's an exercise that you do. Is it the perineum?
Yes.
The perineum wall. There, Google.
Google
Kegels.
It's
K-E-G-E-L-S.
Yes.
I'll just briefly add on to what Pumla said. So Kegels, when I was starting to learn to do Kegels, I was told, When you want to go and do a short call, number one, you start to squeeze. Don't release at once. Mm. Squeeze and like let go slowly.
Yes.
And then, you can always do it, you know, at leisure. You're just seated on your bed and you're just tightening. Yeah. So it helps you.
I think the importance of doing it while you're having doing a number one in the toilet is just to show you the muscle.
Yes,
but it's advisable not to do it.
When
you have only do it.
You should only do it on an empty bladder.
Check for the
empty bladder. Like one or two times
and
like, you know,
when you're peeing.
Remember the lady we brought, that chick who had a flat tummy.
Yes,
also
a healthy lifestyle.
So when you're doing it, you touch your lower belly. Below your belly button, and that's why you concentrate. And please don't be as if you're if you see yourself going up and down, it's wrong. It means you're holding your bum muscles, because you start from there and then you bring it in front like this. Please do these things, because the 50s and 40s are coming.
No, but which makes actually a nice point. You know, you've talked about a tamba and the LT lifestyle. It's very good to partner your Kegels with pulling in your tummy.
Your lower
tummy, because it helps also strengthen that your muscles.
Stop,
which then also help with what you look like in general. Posture.
But even if you have a big belly, you can do your Kegels and down there you're like
Yeah, so more natural ways. I remember when I had just given birth. Okay, so maybe this is for if you're natural, they call it vaginal birth.
Yes.
You can do them earlier. Maybe if you're C-section, you may have to delay them. Because you're always with your child, you're always with your baby. I wish we can use this actually. There's an exercise. My mom always taught me that you put the baby here.
Yes.
The babies will always cling on. And then you do that.
Oh.
Yes.
Then you do that. That helps
the muscles.
Yeah. So, you don't let the baby fall. It's just that this one is not aligned properly.
Mm.
But yeah, it's just and you can go about doing your other things, but it's something you just keep doing.
Mm.
You just, even this puts the baby to sleep.
Yeah.
It soothes the baby to sleep. It's something so easy.
Mm.
And it's like whatever you do with your baby. Like, if this is your child, like, don't just leave your child here. Okay, yeah, maybe you're tired, but try to do things that now that's bonding. For muscle.
Yeah.
In that bonding, you can even do things like this. This is already
the arms.
Working your
you
arms.
You have amazing
it's just,
arms.
It's natural. Like, it's just something natural. You don't need any gadget. It's just you and your baby. You're bonding. Yeah. And
true.
You're also working out.
Yeah. True.
So,
true.
Lifting them.
So your baby yes. can be used as a dumbbell.
Yeah.
Dumbbells.
Dumbbell babies.
I'm curious about the hubs, because I know that there's the pre, you know, pregnancy when you're yeah. preparing for birth, but there's also
to
the
tighten.
After, either to tighten. I don't know what else the hubs
okay,
do. Do you have
so
any information on those?
Yes, I have a bit of information.
Sengana Jim.
So vaginal births, it's important that you use. There's a hub called Kamonye.
Mm.
So you either sit in, yeah, like you boil it, and then you can put it in a basin and sit in there, or you can get just a bit of the leaves and the water. You know that you boiled and keep putting your flower back together. Like you put it back together because I mean it's been through a war and it's well, been through bringing a life on earth, a beautiful it's been you know birthing a beautiful being to come in the world. So you have to be intentional, put it back together. It's important that you squeeze it back together because you need it.
Investment.
You invest.
Wow.
Okay.
Wow. I can imagine how big that child is. But if you then can't you, wouldn't you do it then medically? Because you know there's some medical ways to now. Yeah, medical procedures to sort.
I didn't use any of the natural remedies. Apart from Nazi.
Coconut.
What did you do with the coconut?
Oh, if you have like a UTI, coconut. If you're coconut,
what exactly
one of those all-purpose.
You apply.
Oh, you apply.
Okay, that's all.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So you apply. That said, there is now something called vaginal rejuvenation, which I think you will do.
Eventually.
Yeah, if you can help yourself, you help yourself. Yeah.
Do you need to have finished giving birth?
No.
It doesn't matter.
That's what I thought question. Until I had these ladies. They have their babies at Aga Khan in Nairobi. Mm. So with every baby, Katri.
And I remember telling man, I was like, you know, babe, it's just that money not enough, but otherwise, I would so lift my boobs because I mean, really, I miss them, and you know, you look at them, you're like, why socks? And I know I've had people saying things like, you know, celebrate your body, you know, it had a baby, but I'm like, but I can also, it can also look nice, like you know, and you know the bad thing with those socks, is that your whole body looks like you're kawa, you've worked out. And miserable. And then I'm like, and the only way for them to look nice is for them to gain some more weight and a lot of weight. And that's what, but they're still flat. Then you wear a bra. And then if you look in the side of the bra, they are falling in the bra. They're like, friend. If we are in a bra, at least lift.
Sandico.
So if anything, I would so lift them, and at least I don't want to put those, what do they call silicone. I don't put inserts. I don't want. I feel like there is enough, but just a car lift, you know, to encourage them.
I still get you on that, and I would do the same.
Really?
Actually, it's not even I would do the same. Me, even before I had children, I wanted to have breast implants. I was a real small cup size A, and then I have this some white chest. So and then the boobs are so small, so I'd always wanted to have implants. Then when I got a baby, then believe it or not, this is really improvement. Yeah, so the boobs came, and I was kawa.
Yeah.
But then, you know, many people, they tell us, so even I'll tell people that, I want to lose weight here, I want to lose weight there, and then the people look at you and like, but you're okay.
Yeah.
And I'll tell them that, you're comparing me maybe to the average mother, but I can't compare myself to the average mother. I'll compare myself to maybe who I was before and what I am comfortable with, even if I know, and to be honest with you, I don't want to get that. When I look at pictures of my body before I gave birth,
you don't want that
even me. I feel like my son did mucosa.
Yeah, some curves. Yeah.
Now I'm even so proud of myself. Those days you'd be in the bed. First of all, I like my men small. Can't you be there in the bed? You're both a bone, he's here. Even him, the bone, it touches there. So now I feel like, I got cosam kamit, I'm fine. But the meat has to arrange itself
Properly.
So HR boob, that one, it's just my problem really is to time and priorities.
Mm.
Because I've made the phone calls and I can see that the arrangement financially, I can manage.
Mm.
But I have so many other priorities that I'd rather be
doing. I think that's
with
the thing. Yes, priorities is such a key word.
Actually, if we were rich,
yes,
our priorities would be,
yeah.
Those things would be in our priorities.
Yes, that's true.
So lifting, that one, I have to go for it in the next 3 years.
So we shall
three
be
years
there. Are we together?
Yes,
we are. No. Yeah. Anyway, maybe sooner, but we will go.
Even when it,
like, now, as we have a problem of the mirror, me personally, I like mm-hmm. to be in front of the mirror and I look at myself
sure.
and I'm like, I like that body.
Yes.
Yeah. I want to
yes.
say that, oh my God, that's nice.
Yeah.
Then I see something protruding here, something there. I'm like, well, now what do I do here?
Mm.
Okay, let me do this exercise.
Mm.
And it's important to take photos of yourself when you are.
Meet the weighing scale and them. I look at it, I zoom in. Come on, sometimes when I look at myself, I do like this. In but you need to get there and do turn around.
Turn, take a picture.
I don't even zoom in. I think for me, when I enter a mirror,
I stand straight.
Let me kunyumiza you. I stand straight and I ask myself, do I look like a woman?
What's the alternative?
The
buffalo?
I'd be straight. I'm like, okay. Hey, I look in the mirror and I'm like, I'm beautifully and wonderfully made. Maybe if you strategize and focus and do those exercises, you can see a difference.
Do
the breasts have muscle? Because the butt does have muscle. So
yes,
when you exercise,
breasts should have muscle.
They do.
Like
they
now,
do have,
they yeah, but also when the fallen muscle has fallen,
yeah, after the mass was fallen,
how you return it is but it's the same thing. If people keep thinking that when you're pregnant your bum gets bigger, no, it's the angle at which you're hoisting this mother. Just like also those butt thingies, your body is trimming, but then since this muscle is like this, it looks like it's actually getting bigger, but...
So I only see them in my private time. Like,
yeah.
Like I go around walking with them so that people are looking at them.
True.
I feel like the only way I would change is if people were going to see them, but there's not going to be a time when...
Are you serious?
I never ever think about, even like my tummy, because we barely talked about tummy, but I know that there are people who do like lipo, what?
I would straighten mine. Like, I would,
if anything, it's you, Rich, I was waiting to ask you. Because you speak mostly here about my mom, yeah, you see me like this, but I have
my
this mommy pouch. Would you do like anything surgical?
You know why? I think I'm more worried about what could go wrong.
Oh,
because you're fixing something that was already made a certain way, and then it has
I
been stretched
it.
By pregnancy. So I'm like, what would happen? Like, it's a risk that I don't know.
The
don't
truth
think
is, the way you're speaking makes absolute sense. When you see these things, I was like, hey, if anything. I was like, do the boob, you can add the stomach, then you can get things and add
the other side.
But small bum,
I also wouldn't go surgical on
my body. But I mean, where would you go, madam? Excuse me.
Like, for example,
what do you for mean? You now, for you. Because
come
people
on
go,
you.
Thank
for
you.
Really
no, like, after I'm done with that, because she said you don't have to have had children. I mean, what if your husband is saying something and you're like, okay, but I wouldn't.
Bami, let me tell you something.
Oh, if I wasn't comfortable.
So you know what's so funny? What I'm hearing a lot of you guys talk about, like, I mean, I think there in that direction is what people think. Guys,
not what people think.
Like, just hold on, let me come. Like, if, like, you would only work on it if, like, you are going out for people to see. Or that you're like, oh my God, people were saying this. Like, I hear the people think, but now for me, I don't care. It's not that I don't care what people say. I'm not saying
because
like
we
that.
Know you
but
do
what
that.
I'm doing,
yeah,
what,
that's
what,
you're
yeah,
not the poster
yeah. So what
I
I'm doing, yeah, what I'm doing is for me.
I think we can talk over this over and over again, but I guess you've heard what the ladies had to share. Do share with us what you've done after your children, or what you are willing to do. Will you do the natural or the surgical? Yeah. Until next time, with love from Bump Love.